We talk a lot about nutrition, but there's another aspect of your fitness that a lot of people do incorrectly, and that particular part is strength training or lack thereof, or just not doing it properly, and then a combination of doing way too much cardio. So when you do a lot of cardiovascular training, a lot of running, just nonstop running, and you're trying to lose weight, what ends up happening, especially if your nutrition is not on par, or not where it needs to be, you end up burning through a lot of muscle tissue along the way. You also throw your hormones off, you spike your cortisol levels, and it makes it very difficult to lose body fat because you've burned off a huge energy burner. So muscle tissue takes energy to keep alive, to keep functioning. And when you burn through it because you're doing all of this running, it makes it very difficult for you to burn off body fat that you're not a big fan of because you're burning off the energy system that allows you to do that. Now, if you wanted to continue to do cardiovascular training, you totally could, but you would want to potentially dial it back and increase your strength training. Now, there's a lot of different ways you can do strength training, but if your primary goal is fat loss, getting in better shape, losing inches, having more strength, being more independent, being able to do the cool stuff that you want to do with the people you want to do it with, then there's some stuff that's going to be more efficient and more effective than some other things. And one of those things that isn't going to work, you know, really work very well for you is machine work. So sitting at a local gym on machines, texting in between sets, and kind of dabbling on those, you know, machines that you pay $30 a month for is not gonna cut it. You need to go above and beyond that. Now, what does that look like? Well, actually, it's quite simple. You need to replicate real life. So putting yourself into a position where you're learning how to use your own body, learning how to lunge, learning how to squat, learning how to do push-ups, learning how to do pull-ups, learning how to do rows, learning how to do things that you would typically see or movements that you might replicate out in the real world. Because when you can manipulate your body and manipulate it well, you're gonna be strong. There's just really no way around it. And then you wanna consistently try to get stronger every single week. So doing the same mundane routine every single day is not gonna cut it, not even close. What you wanna do is you want to continuously push the needle. Can you be stronger today than you were yesterday? Can you do a few more push-ups today than you did last week when you did push-ups? Can you do a, 15-pound dumbbell curls rather than 10-pound dumbbell curls? So that's called progression. You're constantly trying to progress in every exercise that you're focusing on that day. And if you do that, you're gonna get stronger every week. If you get stronger every week, you're building muscle tissue that looks great and actually fuels the body and does something for you. Gets rid of the body fat that you're not a big fan of. So if you've been struggling, chances are you're running too much, or you're not strength training properly, or maybe you are doing the right movements, but you're not focusing on progression. You're just doing the same weights over and over and over again. So when you go to the gym next, I want you to try something new, and I want you to try something that might be a little bit harder than what you're used to, and I guarantee you, you'll start to see better results a whole lot faster than you are now. Think about that as you go forward this week. I just wanted to shoot this quick video. Hopefully it helps you. Let me know if it does. Give me a like, comment, subscribe to the social media platform that you're watching this on, because the fitness gods and the social media gods love that stuff. And I will talk to you in the next one. Love ya.